ask ourselves a question this afternoon. Which resurrection will you be in? John 5 verses 21 to 29. As the Father raiseth up the dead and quickeneth them or makes them alive, even so the Son quickeneth whom he will. For the Father judgeth no man, but hath committed all judgment unto the Son, that all men should honour the Son even as they honour the Father. He that honoureth not the Son honoureth not the Father which hath sent him. Verily, verily, truly, truly, I say unto you, he that heareth my word, the Lord Jesus Christ speaking, and believeth on him that sent me, hath everlasting life. What do you have? Everlasting life. It can only come through repentance toward God and faith toward our Lord Jesus Christ. What is repentance? It's a change of mind. Simply come to God and agree with him that you are a sinner, and then put your faith in our Lord and Saviour, Jesus Christ. And not only that, not only hath everlasting life, but and shall not come into condemnation, but is passed from death unto life. Verily, verily, I say unto you, the hour is coming, and now is, when the dead shall hear the voice of the Son of God, and they that hear shall live. This is spiritual resurrection we have here. For as the Father hath life in himself, so hath he given to the Son to have life in himself, and hath given him authority to execute judgment also, because he is the Son of Man. Marvel not at this, for the hour is coming, in the which all that are in the grave shall hear his voice, and shall come forth, they that have done good unto the resurrection of life, and they that have done evil unto the resurrection of damnation. We see here two resurrections, the resurrection of life, and the resurrection of damnation. Which resurrection will you take part in? Will you be a part of? The resurrection of life or the resurrection of damnation? And it all depends on your decision for or against the Lord Jesus Christ. If you believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, your soul will be saved. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Your soul will be saved as a result of faith in our Lord and Saviour, Jesus Christ. And this is a bodily resurrection. Notice there are two resurrections, as I said. Daniel 12, verse 2. And many of them that sleep in the dust of the earth shall awake, some to everlasting life, and some to shame and everlasting contempt or horror. Sleep here is in relation to the body. There's no such thing as soul sleep. You and I have a spirit, a soul, and a body. And our spirit and our soul leave our body at the moment of death. Where will I be 5 seconds after I die? It all depends on what you do with the Lord Jesus Christ. He'll either be your Savior, or he'll have to be your judge. You must make that decision. The moment a person dies, their soul goes to heaven or hell. Their destination, as I said, depends on what they've done with Christ. Matthew 22, verse 23, the first part. The same day came to the Lord Jesus Christ, the Sadducees, which say there is no resurrection. See, just because you don't believe something doesn't mean it's not a fact. It is a fact. You and I will stand before the living God, every one of us shall give account of himself to God. Are you ready to meet God in your present situation? If you die without Christ, where would you be? 5 seconds after you die, heaven for faith in Jesus Christ, or down in hell because you've rejected or neglected the Lord Jesus Christ, who this afternoon can be your Savior. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. John 11 verses 25 and 26, Jesus said unto her, I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die. Believest thou this? That is, never die spiritually. We know that Christians and non-Christians alike die, in the sense that their spirit and soul leave their body. But we must understand, there's more to life than just this body. It's a spirit and a soul which is eternal. These things go out into eternity. People don't think about these things. It's time we stopped and thought about where we're going for eternity. Eternity is forever and ever. We cannot wrap our minds around eternity. And yet it's either heaven through faith in Jesus Christ, or it's in hell and the lake of fire for all eternity, where there's weeping and wailing and gnashing of teeth. God is not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance. Just change your mind. Agree with God that you are a sinner, and then put your faith in our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, in whom we have redemption, through his blood, even the forgiveness of sins. Have your sins been forgiven? Are you on your way to heaven through faith in our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ? Acts 2, verses 29 to 32. Men and brethren, let me freely speak unto you of the patriarch David, that he is both dead and buried, and his sepulchre is with us unto this day. Therefore, being a prophet, and knowing that God had sworn with an oath to him, that of the fruit of his loins according to the flesh, he would raise up Christ to sit on his throne, he seeing this before spake of the resurrection of Christ, that his soul was not left in hell, neither his flesh did see corruption. This Jesus hath God raised up, whereof we all are witnesses. So the first resurrection, or part of it, is seen in 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verses 13 to 18. But I would not have you to be ignorant, brethren, this is speaking to Christians, concerning them which are asleep, that ye sorrow not, even as others which have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so them also which sleep in Jesus will God bring with him. For this we say unto you by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not prevent, that means go before, them which are asleep. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord. Wherefore, comfort one another with these words. That's a comfort to all those who are Christians, all those who are believers in our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Revelation of Jesus Christ, chapter 20, and verse 6. Blessed or happy and holy is he that hath part in the first resurrection. On such the second death hath no power. You might say, well, I only die once, what's the big deal? That is wrong. Yes, if you're a Christian, you die once. But if you're not saved, if you're not a child of God through faith in Christ, you'll have to face the second death. We're going to read about that in a minute. But they shall be priests of God and of Christ, and shall reign with him 1,000 years. Now we'll read about the second resurrection, Revelation of Jesus Christ, and chapter 20, verses 10 to 15. And the devil that deceived them was cast into the lake of fire and brimstone, where the beast and the false prophet are, and shall be tormented day and night forever and ever. He's deceiving the world. This one called the devil, Satan. He's deceiving you if you're not saved. He's blinded the minds of them which believe not, lest the light of the glorious gospel of Christ, who is the image of God, should shine unto them. He's deceiving the whole world. He's got you right where he wants you if you're not a believer. We need to understand he's a deceiver, he's a liar and the father of it. He's a murderer. He hates us. The devil hates us as the whole of humanity. He doesn't want to see us saved. He doesn't want to see us in God's family. We are all the children of God by faith in Christ Jesus. And I saw a great white throne, and him that sat on it, from whose face the earth and the heaven fled away, and there was found no place for them. And I saw the dead, small and great, stand before God. And the books were opened. This is the unbelievers. They're standing before God. And the one on the front here is the Lord Jesus Christ, who today can be your Savior. But in that day, he'll be your judge if you die without Christ as your Savior. And the books were opened, and another book was opened, which is the Book of Life. And the dead were judged out of those things which were written in the books according to their works. And the sea gave up the dead which were in it, and death and hell delivered up the dead which were in them, and they were judged every man according to their works. And death and hell were cast into the lake of fire. This is the second death. Remember I said, there's no need to go into the second death. You don't need to face the second death. You can be saved by the grace of God through faith in our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, and not suffer this second death. And whosoever was not found written in the book of life was cast into the lake of fire. This is the second death. Will you face the second death? You will if you die without Jesus Christ as your Savior. Hebrews 9 verses 24 to 28. For Christ is not entered into the holy places made with hands, which are the figures of the true, but into heaven itself, now to appear in the presence of God for us. This is written to Christians. Nor yet that he should offer himself often as the high priest entereth into the holy place every year with blood of others. For then must he often have suffered since the foundation of the world. But now, in the end of the world, hath he appeared, that's the Lord Jesus Christ, hath appeared to put away sin by the sacrifice of himself. And as it is appointed unto men once to die, but after this the judgment, so Christ was once offered to bear the sins of many, and unto them that look for him shall he appear the second time without sin unto salvation. As we started, I want us to remember this question: which resurrection will you be in? Will it be the resurrection of life, or will it be the resurrection of damnation? There's no need for that. God has made the way of escape through his Son, Jesus Christ, dying upon the cross. Christ died for our sins according to the Scriptures. He was buried, but praise God, the third day he rose again according to the Scriptures. He's a living, loving Savior. It is ours to save your soul from a long-lost eternity. It's either heaven or hell. Heaven through faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. Repentance toward God. In other words, change your mind, agree with God that you're a sinner, and then faith toward our Lord Jesus Christ. Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved. In whom we have redemption through his blood, even the forgiveness of sins. Resurrection of life or the resurrection of damnation. Which one will you be in? It depends what you do with our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. If you're interested in this, look me up. YouTube.com/peace by Jesus Christ. God bless you, and thanks for listening. Look at what I've called scary verses. Scary verses. Proverbs 1 verses 20 to 33. Wisdom crieth without, she uttereth her voice in the streets. She crieth in the chief place of concourse. In the openings of the gates in the city she uttereth her words, saying, how long, ye simple ones, will ye love simplicity? And the scorners delight in their scorning. And fools hate knowledge. Turn you at my reproof. Behold, I will pour out my spirit unto you. I will make known my words unto you. Because I have called and you refused. I have stretched out my hand and no man regarded. But ye have set at naught all my counsel, and would none of my reproof. I also will laugh at your calamity. I will mock when your fear cometh. When your fear cometh as desolation, and your destruction cometh as a whirlwind, when distress and anguish come upon you, Then shall they call upon me, but I will not answer. They shall seek me early, but they shall not find me. For that they hated knowledge, and did not choose the fear of the Lord. They were none of my counsel, they despised all my reproof. Therefore shall I eat of the fruit of their own way, and be filled with their own devices. For the turning away of the simple shall slay them, and the prosperity of fools shall destroy them. But whoso hearkeneth unto me shall dwell safely, and shall be quiet from fear of evil. Proverbs 6 verses 12 to 15. A naughty person, a wicked man, walketh in the frog with a froward mouth, that is, a perverse mouth. He winketh with his eyes, he speaketh with his feet, he teacheth with his fingers. Frowardness is in his heart, he deviseth mischief continually, he soweth discord. Therefore shall his calamity come suddenly, suddenly shall he be broken without remedy. Proverbs 29 verse 1, he that being often reproved hardeneth his neck, shall suddenly be destroyed, and that without remedy. Job 36 verse 18, because there is wrath, beware lest he take thee away with his stroke, then a great ransom cannot deliver thee. Isaiah 63 verse 10, but they rebelled and vexed his Holy Spirit, therefore he was turned to be their enemy, and he fought against them. This is speaking to the people of God in the Old Testament. Daniel 12:2, and many of them that sleep in the dust of the earth shall awake, some to everlasting life, and some to shame and everlasting contempt. Matthew 25 verse 41, then shall he say also unto them on the left, depart from me, ye cursed, into everlasting fire, prepared for the devil and his angels. Luke 12 verses 4 and 5, and I say unto you, my friends, so this is written to Christians, be not afraid of them that kill a body, and after that have no more that they can do. But I will forewarn you whom ye shall fear. Fear him, which after he hath killed, hath power to cast into hell. Yea, I say unto you, fear him. Acts 13 verses 40 and 41. Beware therefore, lest that come upon you which is spoken of in the prophets. Behold, ye despisers, and wonder, and perish. For I work a work in your days, a work which ye shall in no wise believe, or in no way believe, though a man declare it unto you. 2 Thessalonians 1 verses 7 to 9. And to you who are troubled, rest with us. This is speaking to Christians again. When the Lord Jesus shall be revealed from heaven with his mighty angels in flaming fire, taking vengeance on them that know not God. Is that you? Because if it is you, God will take vengeance upon you on them that know not God and that obey not the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. You shall be punished with everlasting destruction from the presence of the Lord and from the glory of his power. That is, the everlasting destruction comes from the presence of the Lord. 1 Peter 4 verses 17 and 18, for the time is come that judgment must begin at the house of God. And if it first begin at us, what shall the end be of them that obey not the gospel of God? And if the righteous scarcely be saved, where shall the ungodly and the sinner appear? Hebrews 10 verses 26 to 31, for if we sin willfully after that we have received the knowledge of the truth, there remaineth no more sacrifice for sins, but a certain fearful looking for judgment and fiery indignation which shall devour the adversaries. For he that despised Moses' law died without mercy under two or three witnesses. Of how much sore punishment, suppose ye, shall he be thought worthy who hath trodden underfoot the Son of God, and hath counted the blood of the covenant wherewith he was sanctified an unholy thing, and hath done despite unto the Spirit of grace.
We know him that has said, vengeance belongeth unto me. I will recompense, saith the Lord. And again, the Lord shall judge his people. It is a fearful thing to fall into the hands of the living God. Exodus 22, verse 24, and my wrath shall wax hot, and I will kill you with the sword, and your wives shall be widows, and your children fatherless. It's written to those in the Old Testament. Deuteronomy 32, verses 39 to 43, see now that I, even I, am he, and there is no God with me. I kill, and I make alive. I wound, and I heal. Neither is there any that can deliver out of my hand. For I lift up my hand to heaven, and say, I live forever. If I whet my glittering sword, that means if I sharpen my glittering sword, and mine hand take hold on judgment, I will render vengeance to mine enemies, and will reward them that hate me. I will make mine arrows drunk with blood, and my sword shall devour flesh, and that with the blood of the slain and of the captives from the beginning of revenges upon the enemy. Rejoice, O ye nations, with his people, for he will avenge the blood of his servants and will render vengeance to his adversaries and will be merciful unto his land and to his people. Psalm 2, verses 1 to 5. Why do the heathen rage and the people imagine a vain thing? The kings of the earth set themselves, and the rulers take counsel together against the Lord and against his anointed, saying, let us break their bands asunder and cast away their cords from us. He that sitteth in the heavens shall laugh. The Lord shall have them in derision. Then shall he speak unto them in his wrath and vex them in his sore displeasure. Verse 9, thou shalt break them with a rod of iron. Thou shalt dash them in pieces like a potter's vessel. Verse 12, kiss the sun, lest he be angry, and ye perish from the way when his wrath is kindled but a little. Blessed are all they that put their trust in him. Psalm 9, verse 17, the wicked shall be turned into hell, and all the nations that forget God. Psalm 50, verse 22, now consider this, ye that forget God, lest I tear you in pieces, and there be none to deliver. Revelation of Jesus Christ, chapter 6, and verses 14 and 15. And the heavens departed as a scroll, and it is rolled together. And every mountain and island were moved out of their places, and the kings of the earth, and the great men, and the rich men, and the chief captains, and the mighty men, and every bondman, and every free man, hid themselves in the dens and in the rocks of the mountains, and said to the mountains and rocks, fall on us, and hide us from the face of him that sitteth on the throne, and from the wrath of the Lamb. For the great day of his wrath is come, and who shall be able to stand? Revelation of Jesus Christ, chapter 20, and verses 10 to 15. And the devil that deceived them was cast into the lake of fire and brimstone, where the beast and the false prophet are, and shall be tormented day and night forever and ever. And I saw a great white throne, and him that sat on it, from whose face the earth and the heaven fled away, and there was found no place for them. And I saw the dead, small and great, stand before God, and the books were opened, and another book was opened, which is the book of life. And the dead were judged out of those things which were written in the books, according to their works. And the sea gave up the dead which were in it, and death and hell delivered up the dead which were in them. And they were judged, every man according to their works. And death and hell were cast into the lake of fire. This is the second death. And whosoever was not found written in the book of life was cast into the lake of fire. God wants your name to be written in the Lamb's book of life, through faith in the Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of God, who died upon the cross, that you and I could have forgiveness for our sins. Christ died for our sins, according to the Scriptures. He was buried, but praise God, the third day he rose again, according to the Scriptures. He could be your Savior this afternoon. What will you do then with Jesus which is called the Christ, and either be your Saviour, or he'll have to be your judge. You must make that decision. Very critical decision to be made. An eternal decision, we might say, an eternal destiny. Your eternal destiny depends on what you do with Jesus Christ. You can either believe on him, you can either come in repentance toward God. That is a change of mind. Simply agree with God that you're a sinner, and then put your faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Do it now before it's forever and eternally too late. At the moment of death, it's either heaven or hell. What will it be for you? Is determined by what you do with the person of our Lord and Saviour, Jesus Christ. And either be your Saviour, or he'll have to be your judge. Make that decision. Make a wise decision this evening. Get right with God before it's forever and eternally too late. Remember that the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ, our Lord. If you're interested in this, look me up, youtube.com/peace by Jesus Christ. God bless you, and thanks for listening. It is appointed unto a man once to die, but after this, the judgment. In whom we have redemption, through his blood even, the forgiveness of sins.